Hello, I'm Leila McKinnon. Welcome to A Current Affair. It's great to be with you. For too long, online trolls have been getting away with the most repulsive behaviour, and it's cost lives. But now there's no more hiding behind a keyboard. It's time to unmask the cowards. Will Australia's tough new laws and six-figure fines be enough to stop these vile attacks?
You're a sad, sad human being.
For 7 years, Anna Stancombe has been copping relentless abuse.
Wonder what docs would do to your children. Maybe it's for the best they go to a foster home.
Still to this day, she only has to log on to the internet to remind herself why she needs to keep fighting her faceless bullies.
You're going down. Bring it, Anna.
She's reading a blog, supposedly about herself.
If you were my teacher, I would shoot you in the head.
Only Anna didn't write it. And she certainly doesn't want anyone to believe what they read about her.
They're trying to assassinate my character. I feel like I'm constantly having to defend myself against untruthful allegations, but the people that have done this have not been held accountable at all. They've just gotten away with it.
The Queensland teacher hates that her children are now old enough to understand the cyber abuse she's endured. Fake accounts, derogatory comments, death threats and constant stalking.
Oh, Anna has taken a holiday, you know, somewhere, and I'm thinking, well, how do these people know this? And they're just, you know, stalking my every move for me to like learn about and read on the internet.
Some of the hate campaign, Anna says, somehow landed in the hands of lawyers to be used against her.
So this is how serious it is that people can, you know, set you up for false allegations just by using, you know, 5 minutes to make a fake profile on Facebook.
The 43-year-old hopes new world-first laws cracking down on trolls will save others from keyboard warriors.
You know, I'm an adult and I was having trouble coping with this. I cannot imagine how a child or teenagers going through similar things, being on, you know, bullied online.
A type of pain that will forever haunt Tick and Kate Everett.
Stick down over that hay patch.
Their beautiful 14-year-old daughter Dolly took her life 3 years ago when she ultimately gave in to cyber bullies. They now dedicate their lives to saving other youngsters through the Dolly's Dream Foundation.
If it helps another family from walking this road, then that's all.
It does matter, and they can only hope heavy fines for online trolls will help stamp out the behaviour.
Do you think that this new legislation will resonate with schoolyard bullies? Will it be enough to deter them?
You know, whether it's a sports commentator or whether it's a celebrity or whether it's just Mary that lives down the road, if we don't have that sort of behaviour online as much, then the younger generation haven't got that example to follow. So you've got to start somewhere.
In the federal government's draft legislation, individuals found guilty will face fines of up to $111,000. Companies will cop a $555,000 bill if they fail to remove the abusive comments from their platform within 24 hours. Prime Minister Scott Morrison says it's time to bring cybercrime in line with the real world.
It's every parent's worst nightmare, and we need to ensure simply that the rules that exist in the real world exist in the digital world. And if you want to be a creep in the digital world, you should face the same punishments and the same rules that you do in the real world.
A world high-profile fashion designer, Alex Perry, says can become even more blurred for celebrities. Having himself been trolled, he's also left to wonder whether the laws could have made a difference for his friend and television personality, Charlotte Dawson, who took her life in 2014.
Like, Charlotte seemed just amazingly great on every level, but you don't know what's going on in somebody. So when you attack them like that, you've got blood on your hands. I wonder if you were the one that she read that just tipped her over the edge. You're sitting in your dump behind your keyboard writing things that, as a human, you shouldn't write and say to somebody else. Just not right.
Alex believes it's too easy for perpetual abusers to get away with it.
To be on one of those platforms, show us your driver's license. Show us your passport. We'll prove who you are. And then write what you want. But then, we can come for you.
And when it comes to business,
do you think $550,000 for someone like Facebook or Twitter is going to do the trick?
You are culpable as much as anybody else because it's your platform. Somebody trips over and falls in my headquarters, I'm responsible. People are being bullied to death on yours. You're accountable.
Few could be more thankful for the proposed legislation than Tristan Moy. She's just spent years fighting to protect her reputation and save her wedding business in Bali.
It was absolutely devastating, both for my business, myself, my reputation.
A judge recently ordered Kelly Smith and Stacey Isaac pay Tristan $150,000 between them for the damage they caused to her online.
I'm still fighting with Facebook to get over 287 comments removed, which is still up, and I've sent another email this morning. So it's a long process. It's not just, you know, we've got an outcome and it all goes away. It's going to be an ongoing thing.
Her win is one thing. The reward is another.
On paper, it was a very expensive lesson. Whether or not we'll ever see or recover any of those costs is another matter. I don't think it's going to stop it completely, but I do think it's going to make people think twice before posting horrible things online about other people.
It's a start in our country's fight to save lives like we've never had to before.
Anything that's going to deter somebody from, you know, upsetting the life of somebody else, then definitely a good step in the right direction.
Be kind and speak even if your voice shakes and ask for help.
And I spoke with Australia's eSafety Commissioner, Julie Inman-Grant, a short time ago. Commissioner, thank you for coming on. What do you think? Are these new laws enough to make social media companies sit up and take notice?
Well, they're giving us some really important tools in our arsenal that we didn't have before. As the first and only online safety regulator in the world, we've had 5 years of practice, and these serious adult cyber abuse powers have been something that have been missing and I think will help us to better protect Australians who are experiencing serious online abuse.
Because people go to these companies and say that they're being abused, that they have continual problems, or they want something taken down, and they just seem to be ignored. Do you think that's going to change?
Well, we're here to hold them to account. We're also here to serve as a safety net for our citizens when things do get missed or fall through the cracks. And that's the role that we've been playing with the youth-based cyberbullying scheme, where we have 100% compliance rate with the social media sites. So every time we've asked them to take down a serious cyberbullying piece of content, they've done so. But there's more that the platforms need to do in terms of enforcing their own policies.
So if somebody is watching who is in a position where they'd like something to be done about some abuse, what should they do? How is it going to be policed?
Right. Well, first of all, the most expeditious way to get this content down is by reporting to the social media site in the first instance. If it isn't taken down and it's considered serious cyber abuse or serious cyberbullying, they can come to us. Again, eSafety serves as a safety net, and they can come to esafety.gov.au, report it to us. That will enliven our powers, and our investigators will look at the case. In many cases, we'll ask the victim if they're willing to talk through the history, the context, so that we can put together the best case possible to compel takedown by the sites. If they're not willing to take that down, then we also have a whole new range of what we call remedial actions or tools to issue penalties, warnings, both against the platforms themselves, but also against the perpetrators.
People feel anonymous online. Will you be able to track down trolls?
Well, anonymity on the internet is very challenging, but it's not an insurmountable challenge. And one thing that this legislation will do will give us more powers to compel basic device information. Now, our investigators are very experienced in investigating the deepest, darkest recesses of the web. That's what they're trained to do. And so I do think this will give us a much better unmasking ability. The other important part of this legal package is that it holds the platforms to account. It shouldn't matter whether the identity of the abusive account is known. If it's violating the platform's policies, they should be suspending the accounts and taking them down. And what this legislation also does is it says, you cannot continue to allow bad actors to reappear on the sites without repercussion. So we're trying to hold the platforms to account, to police their own platforms, to build tools in to make it a safer experience for users, but also to prevent abuse from happening in the first place.
Okay, Commissioner, thank you.
Thank you.